Hello everybody. Today I'm having a look at two knives in Germany. They were recently made, but I think they are not so evident to find actually. So how is that? Well, actually I was a while ago at the knife fair in the German city of Solingen, where, as you probably know, a lot of German cutlery is made. And two companies here, well, Otter knives, which I discussed already because of that beautiful classic Mercator knife which exists since more than 100 years, well, they make that now. They offer this one as a special one, and this is a Karl Schlieper one, which is also not part of their normal catalog. So I will first have a look here at the Otter one, which I think is a perfectly elegant, compact gentleman knife, really wonderfully made. So Otter knives, I mentioned already, they made that beautiful Mercator or cut knife, and also that anchor knife. I have a video on them, you should check them out. They also are more actually active, you could say, in the world of the industrial knives, for butchers and working knives in general. They don't really focus, it seems, on the end user. Now, I saw on their table with all their products, I saw this little beauty, and I hadn't seen it on their website actually, and it turned out, well, actually this was a model that they made in the 1960s, and they still had the, how you call it, the jigs, I believe, the tools to recreate that form, and especially for that convention, that knife fair, they made a number of them. So it's a knife of the 1960s that they made briefly again, and you, I really have to say, man, it's absolutely perfect. You see that it's a really kind of a beautiful timeless design that doesn't get old. So it's around 75 grams heavy. Steel bolsters at the two sides, but there is a bit of brass inside. It's a classic backlock, it's what the Germans do well, backlocks, they do that traditionally well. The fit could be a bit better here, if you feel here at the top, it's not perfectly smooth, but it is really nicely made. I'm not certain what this black inlay is. I don't think it's micarta, I don't think it's it could be wood, or it could be a kind of a plastic. I don't think it's micarta, because then typically it has a bit of a structure. I'm not certain. So it's a classic two-hand knife, opening knife, but without the nail link, but it opens well enough. With a 440C blade, which, considering for gentleman usage, is perfectly acceptable actually. Can you see the Otter messer there? That I think the text is a bit small, but you believe me that it's Otter. 3 inches blade, and you see the cutting edge is almost is a bit less actually, but not much less. And I think here with this particular form, it's nice in the hand. This is, of course, this rounded part doesn't work as well as you could say the coil of a modern Spyderco. I mean, you still should watch out with the classic design if that your finger doesn't slip on the blade. But honestly, I think this is really lovely. Even a lanyard hole, but which I think would look a bit stupid on this kind of knife. But so I think this is really something special. Now this the other one. Look how big it is. So here how this Karl Schlieper. Well, I already discussed a few Karl Schliepers. Karl Schliepers are made by the company called Olberts, which also make a number of other knives actually, and actually they are all made the same way. It's more the Karl Schlieper brand or German I, that you could, here you see that the logo with the I in the middle, it's a brand that was historically in America very popular, and so that one they position more towards the international market actually. So, but they are the same as their older knives these days. In the past it was a different brand, but when they went bankrupt in the 1990s, Mr. Olbers bought it and now makes still traditional knives. Well, it seemed here in this case, he told me that, I think it was him at least, that they had still some older big blades here. And you can see that it is indeed a big blade. And also here for this event, they were making a few handfuls of bigger folders actually. And so, typically for Karl Schlieper, you can read it, the hammered forge. So it's not laser cut out, it's really the old way with hammers that the blade is formed and then ground, which is traditionally set to be a bit better for the strength. Well, I don't think that this Daisy's argument works still, but it's a carbon steel bit, so it will rust already now, while it's not really used often, just a bit on a few boxes to see. It already gets a bit of patina, but that's okay. You should from time to time oil it a bit and wipe it dry. Quite a long blade, as you can see. This is here around. It's more actually the cutting edge was 4 inches, and there is a good centimeter. Let's say half an inch more, actually, almost half an inch more here. So it's quite a big blade, actually. 136 grams. Which I didn't check now, but I think it's more or less the weight of a military. So you have the idea that this is well, not too heavy still, considering the size. And the one that I picked has a jig bone handle inlay. Also typical for Karl Sleeper, the pins are not perfectly flush, so it's a bit, you still have that craft feeling, which I don't mind really very much. What I think is a bit a pity is here, you see the where the blade comes. On the back spring, actually, the blade is a bit lower, which I think it's. Well, I didn't notice when I was checking, when I was picking the knives, because the handle of this one was clearly nicer than the other ones which were still available, which were, for example, yellow plastic and so on. So that's why I didn't really notice that. That this blade is a bit lower. Now, what they all had actually, so it's a slip joint. What they all had is that the back spring. Could be a bit stronger. So yes, it's a perfectly usable general utility knife, but you really should watch out that you don't hit something here at the top, or it may click close on your fingers. It's really the backspring. Well, it works, but it's not as stiff as you would have liked. Of course, such a long blade, you have more leverage than when you turn. That's it's logical that it's more difficult to keep it really stiff. But in general, I like it pretty much. It is the edges here of the blades are nicely rounded here at the top. I mean, both are 3 mm thick, which is a typical pocket knife thickness, you could say. They have brass liners, which I think here also. Of course, it's the same one, but here you see it better. I mean, which I think adds to that classical atmosphere. So a short video of traditional knives made in Europe. Which I think are, well, quite fun. Especially the older one, I must say, that little gentleman knife. Well, it's not that little, it's still 3 inches. Is really totally wonderful. I forgot to say also that with the otter I also got a nice leather pouch. With it, also very traditional. Which is good to keep it in the pocket. I also use this pouch, by the way. You've maybe seen my other video about the Boker CDC Schmelzer, that wonderful modern backlock. Also in classical lines, I also use that pocket, that pouch for it. Because unfortunately, that Boker didn't come with one, which I think it should have. But you see, two wonderful, simple knives. It could have opened a bit smoother. I may oil it a bit, but. And they were both really cheap actually at that knife fair. This one was 23 euros or something, which I think, considering what it is perfectly acceptable. And it's still made in Germany, handmade in Germany, by very nice people, must be said. And here the Karl Schlieper was, well, more or less the same price, maybe 30, I forgot, at that knife fair. The prices were really good. So, I hope you found this interesting, and as usual, feel free to leave feedback.